Hey everyone, I hope you're having a great day. But I want to talk to you about days that you don't feel like you're having a great day. Days that you feel like for whatever reason there is a huge lack, a huge hole in your life. And that hole can be anything. It can be financial, it can be purpose, you know, like you're feeling like there's no fulfillment, no purpose, no drive or direction in your life. You can feel a hole because you don't feel like people that you need care and love from are giving you that care and love. For whatever reason, I want to talk to you about the days that you feel that hole, that deficiency, that lack. My experience on days when I have felt like that, I haven't felt like I could give at all. I didn't have a spare item of energy or emotion to give to anybody else. And it was really hard for me to get over myself, my own issues, to love another, or to listen to another, or to give to another. I want to talk to you about those times. What I have figured out, and actually I was totally inspired this morning by listening to two of my friends talk about their own moments. What I have discovered is that when you are in those moments of deficiency, the best way to get over them is to give of yourself. Both of my friends that I was speaking with this morning have had experiences of lack, you know, feelings of these huge holes in their life for whatever reason. But both find great joy in giving to others. And both in various organizations, in a volunteer capacity. And I have another friend who I've actually told you about, who volunteers weekly. And regardless of whether it's for your purpose, you know, to express your purpose, or just to get past that feeling of lack, it is such a profound thing. And you know, it's so interesting because naturally we feel like we need to hoard things to us. When we feel we're experiencing a lack, we want to hoard things, whether it's money or time or energy or love or whatever. We hold it close to our chest, thinking that in hoarding it to us, we will actually be able to survive. It's like that natural instinct kicks in to hoard it close. But in reality, and this is what I've discovered and what my two friends were talking about this morning, the more you give of yourself to others, when you just buck up and you force yourself to give, even though you don't feel like you have one thing left to give, it gives back to you. So when you're giving to another, say you have a spare 50 cents or whatever, and you loan it to somebody, or you buy them lunch, or you know, you even give it to the man on the corner, there's a huge feeling that comes with it, because in giving, you subconsciously are having the feeling that you've got plenty. So if you give of your energy and your time when you don't feel like you can, there's like this subconscious click in your mind that makes you think, I've got plenty. I've got what I need. And in giving, you get back in return. And you're just going to have to take it on faith from me, because I know it doesn't sound like it makes sense. I know it's completely illogical and against your natural instinct to hoard. But if you just muscle past that moment of hesitation and give of yourself, you will get back this feeling that you've got enough, that your supply is unending. It's the coolest phenomenon, and it works every single time. If you can get past your feeling of lack and give in whatever way you can, I guarantee you that you will feel supplied, and your feelings will change just like that. So if you're feeling a hole today and you feel like it needs to be filled, don't fill it by hoarding. Give, and you will be filled. I guarantee it. Have a great week. We'll see you on Wednesday.